Hi, in this Excel tutorial, we're going to go over how to edit a macro in Excel. And in doing so, we'll do a brief overview of how the VBA editor is laid out. If you'd first like to see how to create a macro, please do take a moment to watch our tutorial on that. So the macro we're editing is one that takes this little bit of data that's on the screen and makes it look more presentable, like this. But we need to revise it. We need to change the report name from Sales Report to Weekly Associate Sales. We can easily do that in the VBA editor. And by the way, if you enjoy this tutorial, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel for even more tips. The VBA editor is the tool that Excel uses for macros. You can access it from the Developer tab and click Macros. Here we see a list of our available macros. Select the one that you need, in this case, Report Cleanup, and step into. Now you could also choose Edit, but if your macro is stored in your hidden personal workbook like mine is, and you choose Edit, then you'll need to first unhide and open that workbook, so you have a few more steps to do that way. So we'll click Step Into. You should now be in the macro you selected. You can tell this because the name of the macro we selected is highlighted here in yellow. But let's go over some of what we see on our screen. It'll be good to have a basic understanding of what some of these items are. So on the left here, you see that we have two VBA projects, Macro Edit Example and Personal. A project is just another name for a workbook. The Macro Edit Example is the workbook with the data that we want to format. The Personal Workbook is where all my macros are stored. This is a hidden workbook auto-created by Excel just for macros. So beneath each of these, you see different things. Beneath the macro edit example, you see each sheet in the workbook. And then beneath the personal macro, you see modules. So in my personal macro workbook, a module was created for each macro that I've ever created. And even after deleting a macro, the module stays, even if it is empty. So the macro we're editing is here in module 9. So our macro is a sub-procedure. Not real important to know what that is for this example, but that's what this sub here stands for. And your macro is located between this sub up here with the name, and if you scroll to the bottom, down here where it says End Sub. And in between those two lines, we can add more VBA code, delete code, or change the existing code. In this example, all we want to do is revise the report name. So there's a lot of code here. So with my cursor in the part of the screen where the code is, I'm just going to use Control F to search for sales report. And by the way, if this macro is one that you cannot easily re-record or it will be catastrophic should it become ruined, it's a good idea to copy it. You can just select everything and use Control C to copy and then paste it and save it elsewhere, a Word document even. And this way, should you have a macro emergency, you can just paste it back in. To confirm that we're in the right place, there's a couple of things that we can look at. First, sales report is in quotation marks and doesn't have an equal sign. This lets us know that it's a text entry. And then if you look above it, the cell B2 is the one that contains the report name that we want to revise. Once we're certain that we're in the right place, we simply highlight report name and we type in the new name that we want for our report. And then click Save. And we can close the VBA editor, click OK. And now when we rerun the macro, it will update with the new report name. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on how to change a macro in Microsoft Excel. If you did, please make sure to like the video and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks.